It's no secret. The consensus number one pick in this year's NBA draft is John Wall. But what exactly has everyone buzzing? In a word, speed. To find out just how quick John Wall really is, we'll put him to the test right here in the Sports Science Lab. To test his quickness off the dribble from the top of the key, our smart speed timing gates will prompt John to either cut right or left. First, as a baseline, we have John run the test without a ball. 3, 2, 1. John reacts to the directional cue and on average gets to the basket in 2.8 seconds. Then we gave him the ball. He reacts to the light trigger in only 253 milliseconds. That's faster than a cheetah takes a single stride at top speed. In just two steps, John accelerates to almost 50% of his top speed and cuts around the gate to the basket in less than 2.9 seconds. Incredibly, dribbling a ball slows John down on average by less than 0.05 of a second. In fact, Wall is even faster with the ball than Kevin Durant runs without the ball. And incredibly, in a straight sprint at his top gear, John Wall is flat out faster than NBA All-Stars Chris Paul and Deron Williams. That kind of crazy speed is why John Wall could make a big impact in the NBA from day one. For Sports Science on ESPN, I'm John Brinkus. We know John Wall is fast.
Look at that speed.
Incredibly, in a straight sprint at his top gear, John Wall is flat out faster than NBA All-Stars Chris Paul and Deron Williams. But to be an elite point guard in the NBA, you need more than speed. You need court vision and the ability to finish strong. First, we'll test John's vision. When you're trying to dish off to somebody, I mean, you're not really even looking where you're throwing.
Nah, sometimes you just got to read it, you know, read and react. So it's tough. You know, I watch Steve Nash and Magic Johnson. Those guys are perfect at it, so you learn from them.
One random target will lock on green. Keeping his eyes on the basket, John needs to hit that target using only his peripheral vision. Humans have a normal field of vision just under 180 degrees. When looking straight ahead, the image directly in front of the eye is clearest, and the targets John will be aiming at will be in the far corners of his peripheral vision, close to 85 degrees from his central field of view. At that angle, his visual acuity will be reduced by 97.5%. Meaning he'll only have use of 2.5% of his effective vision. Here we go. Woo! Amazingly, using the far extremes of his peripheral vision, John hit the target with the behind-the-back pass on his first try. Not only that, he also nailed the target with a bounce pass between his legs. You can see them.
It's just like, it's a little bit you can see. You can't see the whole thing. You just can see a little bit of it, so you got to figure out which one is right.
To measure his ability to finish strong at the hoop, we wired John up with our biomechanical assessment system. 3, 2, 1. John vertical leap is a massive 39 inches. That's a higher vertical leap than even Kobe Bryant. Combine Steve Nash's court vision with the dunking skills of Derrick Rose, and you get John Wall, the prototype of a point guard in the NBA. For Sports Science on ESPN, I'm John Brinkus.